What is our status? I'll not take much time. I'll take only another 5 minutes of time. In 2019-20, particularly about, I'm not talking about the central budget, I'm talking about the state budget only. Sectors such as energy. The energy sector is one sector which has grown in manifold manner in Andhra Pradesh for the last, of course, not only now, for the last 5 years, 10 years or so, 10-15 years, I'll say. The growth is about 247%, and the particularly the budget, recent budget, the allocation 2019-20, the allocation towards the energy sector is increased by 247%, and welfare towards the welfare of minorities and SC, ST and poor and downtrodden has gone up by 157%. Therefore, these are all the priorities of the government of Andhra Pradesh, where the issues are being concentrated and working towards the development of these areas. And fish and prawn production contributed about 7.4% of state towards the state GSDP. See, this is one area which earlier Kerala was in upbeat mode and Tamil Nadu was in forefront, and now we have excelled and competed with the other states, and we are in the forefront now. And the export of marine products have increased from $1,559 million in 2014-15 to $1,932 million in 2018-19, and these exports are likely to go up further in these areas. State government, as I have already told, there will be intense efforts from the state government to promote and support the industry. Particularly, the government has facilitated the total investment of 20,000 crores from 39 large mega industrial units in the state since June 2019. So we are planning to set up more and more mega industrial parks to encourage the industry, to set up the industries there. Particularly, government of Andhra Pradesh now has decided to focus on MSME sector, which is the priority of the central government also, Modi ji government. And government is focusing on MSME sector with over 6,572 MSME units getting established in the state with a total investment of 1,840 crores, providing employment to almost about 50,000 persons, families. So this is the sector which will address the employment problem for the youth and educated. So we will have to concentrate more on this MSME sector. And the focus should be more on the basic industries. And very recently, the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh has set up a foundation stone for a steel factory in Kadapa, high-grade steel. And 3,148 acres of land has been allotted. And an MOU has been entered into with NMDC, which is Government of India undertaking. So this will generate employment, this will contribute to the state GSDP, and this will increase the per capita income. And such type of industries are to be encouraged, because AP is a mineral rich state, and wherever minerals are available and the related industries also, the should be established by the industrialist. Development of ports. When it comes to the development of ports, AP government is negotiating with the central government, talking to the central government to set up, apart from the existing ports, to set up few more ports in Andhra Pradesh. One is Machilipatnam, second is Ramaipatnam, third is Bhavanapadu. So negotiations are on, and this will substantially contribute to the export and imports of various products. So the whatever is needed by the industry, the government headed by the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, is prepared to give support, extend the support. As I have already told you, without any bias, without taking into consideration the caste, creed and religion, and also the state which they belong to, it is the peaceful atmosphere and peaceful living and sustainable development what are required here. Therefore, I assure you in this regard that this government would do everything possible to achieve this objective, and we seek your cooperation also in this regard. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your most analytical points in every field what an industrialist can vision about being in Andhra Pradesh. Sir, one more request, sir, from all outside. After this election or whatever it is, we request you to be with the dynamic chief minister to have an interaction with this group, sir. With only strictly, we'll make sure that only industrialists will be there, sir. And also a closed meeting with the core committee to talk about only the development of Visakhapatnam, sir. And I request KRP Prakash from Steamship Agents Association, Kancharal Prakash, to propose a vote of thanks. And also Vice Chairman AP Chambers.
Hi, hello, namaste, it's me Madhavi Lata. Please subscribe.
Hi, I'm Manara Chopra, and please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Subscribe.
Please subscribe. Please do subscribe. Please subscribe to
Tambola TV.
Tambola TV. Chaka.
Please do watch and subscribe Tambola TV.
What is Bintex Futures? Bintex Futures is a global cryptocurrency exchange and payment company. Bintex Futures is a decentralized crypto exchange. You can buy and sell cryptocurrency with highest leverage. Bintex Futures has its own token, BNTX. Why BNTX tokens are beneficial to buy and hold? We have our own crypto exchange and unique Bintex Pay wallet. We can store BNTX tokens in Bintex Pay wallet, and you can utilize BNTX tokens for recharges, hotel bookings, and bill payments, etc. Being a long-term BNTX holder will make your interest rate grow. Still, Bintex Futures lets you withdraw your BNTX tokens at any moment. Buy it, pay with it, hold it. Bintex Futures, make crypto real.